there. Yeah, this is at the University of New South Wales at the School of Mathematics and Statistics. My name is Thomas Britz, and I'll be going through this problem from discrete math, MATH1081, topic 5, the topic on graph theory. And we're going to be looking at problem 4, which deals with a graph G with vertex set V and edge set E. And for this graph, we're told that the vertex degrees are as follows: 4, 3, 3, 2, 2. And then we're asked to find out how many edges are there in the graph. What's the size of this edge set? So, first of all, what's a vertex degree? Well, we've got 5 numbers here, and each of those numbers correspond to one of the vertices of V. So we've got, for instance, for the 4 there, we've got a vertex, which we can draw as a dot. And the 4 there says that there are 4 edges incident with that vertex, or 4 lines that we draw from that dot. So we have one vertex which has 4 of these edges going from it. We have another vertex which has 3. In fact, we've got 2 vertices which have 3 edges going out from them. And then the 2 remaining vertices will have 2 edges going out from them. Okay, now to solve this problem, to work out the number of edges in this graph, we can use the handshaking lemma. And here it is. So it says that if we add up all the degrees here, then we get twice the number of edges in the graph. And why is that? Well, that's if we look at all of the degrees of the vertices. So here's a vertex, and it might have, for instance, 4 degrees. And if we count the number of times it shakes hands, so to speak, with another vertex, so that's when there's an edge between them, then we'll be counting these edges twice. We'll be counting this edge for this vertex when it shakes hands with that vertex, but we'll also be counting this edge when this vertex shakes hands with the first one. So that's where you get that identity from. It's a simple but very useful little identity. Okay, so what do we need to do? Well, let's use this lemma. So we've got the number of degrees here, add them together. So we have that 4 plus 3 plus 3 plus 2 plus 2. That's 14. And that's apparently equal to 2 times the number of edges. So we see that the number of edges is just equal to 7, or 14 divided by 2. Okay, so we can now answer that question. The number of edges in the graph was 7. Okay, now the next thing that we have to do is to draw a simple example of such a graph. In other words, we're trying to find a graph that has these vertex degrees here and is simple. So first of all, what does simple mean? Well, it just means that we are not allowed to draw loops like this. So a vertex with an edge going to itself is forbidden. And we also forbid any sort of situation like this where we've got 2 vertices and at least 2 or more edges. So that's also forbidden. So in other words, there's at most one edge between every pair of vertices. So that's what simple means. Okay, so if we're trying to draw a graph with these vertex degrees, and it's a simple graph, then we can start off by taking this 4 here. So that 4 means that the sum vertex, let's draw it here, which is connected by 4 edges, and each of those edges ends in another vertex, like so. So now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vertices. Ah, cool, because that's exactly the number of vertices here. So we've drawn all the vertices. We've also drawn all of the edges going out from this vertex here with degree sequence 4. Okay, what about the 3 here then? Well, we can choose any of these vertices. They all alike, so without generality, without loss of generality. we can assume that the 3 there matches up with this vertex here. So in other words, the vertex here has degree 3. So here's one of the edges, and let's just draw an edge here and an edge there. It doesn't matter which ones we draw it to. If we'd drawn, instead of going from here to there, we'd draw it there to there. That would be the same situation because we can swap these around if we want. Okay, what else? Now let's look at the very last number here, 2. And in fact, we've got 2 of these 2s. But if you look at which vertices they might correspond to, these 2 2s, then it can't be this one. That had degree sequence 4. Can't be that one. That had degree sequence 3. So it has to, these vertices here, these 2 vertices, have to be 2 of the vertices down here of this, this, and this vertex set. So in particular, we have to have at least one of the vertices corresponding, or vertices with degree 2, to be one of these here. So let's just say, well, this one or this one, it doesn't matter, because again, they have the same adjacencies. So let's say that it's this one here. Okay, so now we've got rid of, or now we've dealt with that number. Now we just have to look at the remaining here. But we've given all the edges. We've drawn all the edges to that one, all of the edges on that one, and all of the edges on that one. So if we want to draw any more edges, then we can only draw more edges between this one and this one. And we do have to do that because we still don't have 2 and 3 here as the degree sequences, so let's do that. Oh, okay, look at this. Now we've got degree 3 here and degree 2, and we're in fact done. Cool. And we've actually shown one more thing, and which concludes the problem. That's that there was only one way to choose this, apart from the with loss of generalities. The graph will look like this up to isomorphism if it has these degree sequences and is simple. So that's that.